Hold on. I forgot I had this on. Crap. Just to make sure this is all up and going. Like refresh my thing here just so I can make sure everything's up and hunky dory. Alright, seems to be good now. Just give me a second, guys. I am. Get this going. Okay, get that set up. All right, hello everyone. I am back with another thing. I don't know. I'm back with another stream, and I am just here. The last time I streamed this, I just finished becoming a, being promoted as a Spectre. So we have that going. I'm gonna upgrade more of this. So, what do I need to do next? Now that I think about it. Your friends is continuing the Geth. As a reward, the council has granted you a Spectre status in case you track down the Spectre down. Okay, what do I do next then? Ambassador will provide you a ship and a crew. Meet him at the Alliance docking bay, accessible through the center elevator of the C section. Okay. Okay, we just gotta get there.
I hope he's okay.
Casually jog. Let's go, buddy. Oh, Rich, probably. Yeah. Should be good. Hello, elevator.
In other news, ExogeniCorp is still denying reports that one of their survey teams has gone missing in the Hades Gamma Cluster. When asked why communication with the survey team was suddenly cut off last week, company officials refused to comment.
Okay, let's go.
I've told you before, you're not allowed in here.
This one believes it has the right to move freely through this area.
You're creating a public disturbance.
I'm just moving. Not sure where I'm going exactly, so. Just gonna keep going. Pretty much. Citadel Tower, Financial District, Port Access, Board Locations, Flutz, C-Sect. Alright. Yep, this is it.
Binary Helix has settled out of court with a Krogan group that had accused the Genetics Corporation of fraud. The Krogan group had contracted Binary Helix to perform studies with a long-range goal of curing their genetic sterilization. The group later sued for a return of investment money when the study produced no viable results.
You're not gonna say anything about that, Brian? Okay. Hello, Ambassador and Captain.
I've got big news for you, Shepard. Captain Anderson is stepping down as commanding officer of the Normandy. The ship is yours now.
Oh, wow.
She's quick and quiet, and you know the crew. Perfect ship for a Spectre. Treat her well, Commander.
This isn't right. The Normandy belongs to you.
You needed your own ship. A Spectre can't answer to anyone but the Council. And it's time for me to step down.
Come clean with me, Captain. You owe me that much.
I was in your shoes 20 years ago, Shepard. They were considering me for the Spectres.
What happened?
I failed. I couldn't make the cut. It's not something I'm proud of. Ask me later and I'll tell you the whole story. For now, all you need to know is, I was sent on a mission with Saren, and he made sure the Council rejected me. I had my shot. It came and went. Now you have a chance to make up for my mistakes.
What kind of leads do we have?
Saren's gone. Don't even try to find him. But we know what he's after. The Conduit. He's got us Geth scouring the Traverse looking for clues.
We had reports of Geth in the Pharos system shortly before our colony there dropped out of contact, and there have been sightings around Novaria.
Find out what Saren was after on Pharos and Novaria. Maybe you can figure out where the Conduit is before he does.
The Reapers are the real threat.
I'm with the Council on this one, Shepard. I'm not sure they even exist.
But if they do exist, the Conduit's the key to bringing them back. Stop Saren from getting the Conduit, and we stop the Reapers from returning.
I'll stop.
Got me. Oh, what is with that voice change?
We have one more lead. Matriarch Benezia, the other voice in that recording? She has a daughter, a scientist who specializes in the Protheans. We don't know if she's involved, but it might be a good idea to try and find her. See what she knows. Her name's Liara, Dr. Liara Tassoni. We have reports she was exploring an archaeological dig on one of the uncharted worlds in the Artemis Tower.
Sorry, I needed... glad you came in. I kind of needed a minute from all that, news.
Maybe I can get to Novaria before the Geth.
It's your decision, Commander. You're a Spectre now. You don't answer to us.
But your actions still reflect on humanity as a whole. You make a mess and I get stuck cleaning it up.
Oh, get it off your ass.
I'll do whatever it takes to stop Saren.
Not exactly the answer I was looking for, Shepard. Remember, you were a human long before you were a Spectre. I have a meeting to get to. Captain Anderson can answer any questions you might have.
Excitement. Yeah, yeah. News of pure excitement. Let's go with that. Going in my ship.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress.
Oh, I guess I'm dirty. These two are just having fun.
I heard what happened to Captain Anderson. Survives 100 battles and then gets taken down by backroom politics. Just watch your back,
right.
Commander. Things go bad on this mission, you're next on their chopping block.
Saren's out there somewhere, and we're gonna find him.
Everyone on this ship's behind you, Commander. 100%. Intercom's
we'll
open.
Go get Lara that at first. Okay.
The crew? Now's the time.
Now we do things my way.
This is Commander Shepard speaking.
We have our orders. Find Saren before he finds the conduit. I won't lie to you, crew. This mission isn't going to be easy.
For too long, our species has stood apart from the others.
Now it's time for us to step up and do our part for the rest of the galaxy. Time to show them what humans are made of.
Our enemy knows we're coming.
When we go into the Traverse, Saren's followers will be waiting for us. But we'll be ready for them, too.
This is the most important mission any of us have ever been on.
The fate of an entire galaxy is at stake. We will stop Saren, no matter what the cost.
Well said, Commander. Captain will be proud.
He is better anymore. Damn.
The captain gave up everything so I could have this chance. We can't fail.
Yes, sir.
All right, before we leave, as you even said yourself, we'll get out of here. We're going to exit the Normandy real quick. Thanks, God. Yeah, let's go outside real quick. So where is Lyra for? Where is Lyra? I never actually gotten any,
Equalizing interior pressure with exterior atmosphere.
Oh, God. Love. I never actually got an idea of where she,
ashore.
Where they were.
Exo Presley has the deck.
So where can I find this Lyra, where can I find her, Echo? Like, I know you can't spoil anything for me, but helping me find this person is probably for the best for me right now. That. Get on the Normandy. Oh, she's off planet. Get on the Normandy. Okay.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress.
I didn't think I was out there for that long.
Logged. The commanding officer is aboard. Exo Presley stands relieved.
All right.
Commander, something you need?
I have to go.
All right, see you.
All right, let me go to talk to Ed. Get off the planet here. Assuming I go here. Yeah. Oh, I have to get on top of that. Okay. Hold on. Artemis Tau Cluster. Hawking, Ida, Armstrong, Nebula, Voyager Cluster. Now it's Artemis. Argos, Horsehead Nebula Cluster, Artemis Tau. This is what you're talking about? Yeah, Liar's Dig Site, yeah. We'll go here. And then also Athens. On. So which one is she on? Is she on Athens? Knossos Star System, huh? Okay. Alright. We'll head here then. Yeah, let me just pop a drink real quick. This just shot me out. It won't be in here anymore. Okay. Armani. Theorem. Zarkross. Okay. Theorem. Alright. Okay. This is where we're gonna land then. Let's go. Look at you being my little encyclopedia. Telling me they're in the lava, Joker. What the hell? What the hell, current control? Okay, controls. Not a little sensitive. Oh, what the hell? Oh, Jesus. Okay, I can jump. Okay. Look at your map. Okay, hold on. I'm assuming they're in the refinery. Set a flag. Oh, I know that. I'm assuming I'm heading to the refinery. This is weird controls. Okay, minigun. Oh god. Oh my god, I was driving backwards the entire time. There's a booster. I found the booster. Oh, okay. And big booms. Minigun. Zoom. Okay. It's the interesting development. There are enemies on my map. They're probably at the refinery. Oh, hello. Oh, God. Oh, my God. It's the Covenant. I'm gonna drive into the one of these lavas. Oh god, no, stop, stop, stop. Okay. I'm gonna drive into one of these lava pools. I just know it. Oh, I'm saving.
Only a fool punches a map back in the mouth. Be sure to sneak around and stay safe.
And then, okay. I'm like trying to actually control here. This is not best controls. Okay, that's my jump. Oh god, I shot myself. Ah! Okay. 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 Don't believe it. Yeah, I can tell. I'm not bad at driving. This is bad at driving. How do I get out of the Mongo? Okay. Okay, so I can't get out. I had no idea. Hi, bud. Goodbye, bud.
Perimeter secured.
I'll just manual override. Cool. Let's go over here. Let's go. So funny, man. All right, I gotta go over there and do the same thing. Get back. I need to open the other gate, though. Yeah, I know that. I was trying to do that before, but you got angry. There we go. Okay. Alright. Going back. Going out. Oh, right. There's a... just... there. Let's go. You. That's how you do it. That's how you do it. The distortion way. Stats are... oh yeah, I should probably just pay attention to this. Hold on. Mixture of both is not a good idea. Oops, I actually ran into someone. My mistake. Not my fault. It was the Mako, whatever. Ah, pedestrians! I didn't do it. It was the Mako. I'm completely innocent. Look at my sincere eyes. Oh, my signal's jammed. This is, it looks like I have to go the long way. Okay. Barrier.
Bundle up. My way.
Shield back if I'm crouched up like that. Oh no! Is he dead? Yeah, I figured I have a sniper rifle, but I can't even figure out where the hell any of my things are. Don't come back. Don't start anything, please. Oh my god. Damn sniper rifle LB. Oh my fucking god. I really am a damn idiot. Comes back to life once everyone's dead. That makes sense. All the enemies? Yep, he's back. Okay, he's not dead forever, thank God. At the very least, just like, he's done with the planet.
Medigel deployed.
Okay. Yep, here they are. Here they come. Where are they? Oh, okay. Oh. Oh no. Ah, it's an ugly bastard. Oh crap. That's why you said heal up. A little late for that, but I now know. Good God. They are definitely a real piece of work there, that's for sure. Real piece of work. Tali's dead, oh shit. Jail, that helps. another one. Covered, bud. Yeah, I know they're recovering. Major oof. And now we're back at the taco. I'm going back over here for a corner. Okay, both my enemies, well, both my team enemies. Yeah. Yeah, I knew I was gonna die there, so I was just gonna resume that. Tally this time. How peculiar. Things in the chain, especially since I don't know what the hell I'm doing right now, if I'm being honest, dude. I do not get your messages at the same time, Echo. Okay. The storm shotgun instead of the scimitar. As for sniper rifle, oh, sorry. Yeah. As for snipers. I have a Hammer 2, Avenger 1, Reaper 1. Thank you. Yeah, so I was using the hammer. Pretty limited on what I have, Echo. I have sabotage, shield boost, and overload. Or charge with overload would definitely help. Dead. Okay. Okay, I guess I just get insta killed with that. Alright. Sucks. Okay, well, at least I'd have a better idea what to do now. Clearly, my hammer is very overpowered. Yeah, I just dropped dead all of a sudden. Like, I got hit. I had full health and shield, and I died. Sounds like they make you a tally first. Okay. I got your attention. I'm back here. They're gonna keep shooting you from that angle, Tally. Just keep suddenly appearing right there now. As funny as that would be, no. I haven't. Okay, I would need. I would use it for me chilling for the big boy. Oh my god, they keep overloading my damn gun. These guys are starting to... There we go. Once I get that crit in and make them recoil, that makes it end. There we go. I think that's all of them. Please. Okay. See, focus on healing. I know. Oh my God, do not bring him over here, dude. Dead. Oh my God. I hated that so much. Going in. That was the mini boss, of course. You motherfucker! Apparently this sniper rifle was like the best thing I had these days. Backing up. Tali, move. Shepard, don't be stupid. My God. They killed both my squads. Back up, you slackers. Thank you. I don't know why you bother put your guns away. We're about to pull them out in just a moment. On second thought, it feels like we're about to hit something. This is like a mess.
Hello? Can somebody help me? Please?
Hi? You sure you're the one I'm supposed to look for?
Can you hear me out there? I'm trapped. I need help.
Are you okay? What happened to you?
Listen, this thing I'm in is a Prothean security device. I cannot move, so I need you to get me out of it, all right?
Your mother is working with Saren. Whose side are you on?
What? I am not on anybody's side. I may be Benizia's daughter, but I'm nothing like her. I have not spoken to her in years. Please, just get me out of here.
How'd you end up in there?
I was exploring the ruins when the Geth showed up, so I hid in here. Can you believe that? Geth beyond the veil! I activated the tower's defenses. I knew the barrier curtains would keep them out. When I turned it on, I must have hit something I wasn't supposed to. I was trapped in here. You must get me out, please.
You brought this by yourself.
Any suggestions on how we can help?
There is a control in here that should deactivate this thing. You'll have to find some way past the barrier curtain. That's the tricky part. The defenses cannot be shut off from the outside. I don't know how you'll get in here. Be careful. There was a Krogan with the Geth. They have been trying different ways to get past the barrier.
Okay. I noticed. Kali's dead. Krogan, I forgot his name. He's nearly dead. She's just down. She's now on the job. Dude. Yep, that's all of them. You need help up there, bud?
Indeed, I'll follow.
Okay, good. You just need to get up. Here, have some help. I'm not exactly sure how to heal myself. I'm healing myself and them. But, I mean, I don't... Am I able to heal separately then? Just guess that shit. That's awesome. I'm gonna look back here real quick though. Let's see here. Alright, so for assault rifle, I have the Avenger 2 and the Banshee 2. Though it looks like this Avenger still seems a bit better. The fact that this is what it looks like, I'm afraid of what's about to happen here. Wow. Oh, hi.
Oh, how did you get in here? I didn't think there was any way past the barrier.
Superior firepower.
We have to get you out of here before more Geth arrive.
Yes, you're right. I've seen enough of them to last a lifetime. That button should shut down my containment field.
They'll have the Lance equipped, not the Avenger. Okay.
Any idea how we get out of this place?
There is an elevator back in the center of the tower. At least I think it's an elevator. It should take us out of here. Come on! I still cannot believe all this. Why would the Geth come after me? Do you think Benezia's involved?
Seren's looking for the conduit. You're a Prothean expert. He probably wants you to help him find it.
The conduit? But I don't know...
What the hell was that?
He got through.
Not stable. That mining laser must have triggered a seismic event. We have to hurry. The whole place is caving in.
Joker, get the Normandy airborne and lock in on my signal. On the double, mister.
Aye, aye, Commander. Secure and away. ETA 8 minutes.
He needs to move faster.
If I die in here, I'll kill him.
I appreciate that. Oh, I do have the lance equipped, I guess. I'll double check when I get a second. Here. Oh, I see him pulling out his gun.
Surrender. Or don't. That would be more fun.
In case you didn't notice, this place is falling apart.
Exhilarating, isn't it? Thanks for getting rid of those energy fields for us. Hand the doctor over.
Whatever it is you want, you are not getting it from me.
Killed that bastard.
She'll stay with us, thanks.
Not an option. Saren wants her. And he always gets what he wants. Kill him. Spare the Asari if you can. If not, doesn't matter.
Okay. Hold on. Hold on. Oh shoot. He killed Talit. Oh my god, he killed my team. Bruds. The way you play is so different. Okay, he can self-regenerate. That's an issue. Okay, he either zoomed behind me or he just teleported. Oy vey. Oy vey, oy vey, oy vey. Jesus Louise.
Kill him. Spare the Asari.
Oh, come on. I don't like how he just rushes towards me like that. Seriously, he rushes towards me. Oh, is it? Yeah, sorry about that. I don't know how to really fix that without having to, you know, stop the stream and reboot it.
Kill him. Spare the Asari if you can.
I suddenly have no health now, like no healing things now. Okay, no. Oh my god. I suddenly. Good night, Echo. And why did I suddenly die? Like, why do I suddenly not have any health now? Okay. I gotta get through this.
Thank you.
Okay, that. Draining my health. I don't know how to stop it though. Come on. Alright, it's clear at this point that I need to kill him first in order to actually, before I kill all his soldiers. Because if I kill him first, he doesn't get all aggressive. no. Oh, come on. I don't think he actually died.
Too close, Commander. 10 more seconds, we would have been swimming in molten sulfur. The Normandy isn't equipped to land in exploding volcanoes. They tend to fry our sensors and melt our hull. Just for future reference.
We almost died out there, and your pilot is making jokes?
It's a coping mechanism. You'll get used to it.
I see. It must be a human thing. I don't have a lot of experience dealing with your species, Commander. But I am grateful to you. You saved my life back there, and not just from the volcano. Those Geth would have killed me or dragged me off to Saren.
What did Saren want with you? Do you know something about the conduit?
Only that it was somehow connected to the Prothean extinction. That is my real area of expertise. I have spent the past 50 years trying to figure out what happened to them.
How old are you exactly?
I hate to admit it, but I am only 106.
Damn! I hope I look that good when I'm your age.
A century may seem like a long time to a short-lived species like yours.
How?
But among the Asari, I am barely considered more than a child. That is why my research has not received the attention it deserves. Because of my youth, other Asari scholars tend to dismiss my theories on what happened to the Protheans.
I've got my own theory on why the Protheans disappeared.
With all due respect, Commander, I have heard every theory out there. The problem is finding evidence to support them. The Protheans left remarkably little behind. It is almost as if someone did not want the mystery solved. It is like someone came along after the Protheans were gone and cleansed the galaxy of clues. But here is the incredible part. According to my findings, the Protheans were not the first galactic civilization to mysteriously vanish. This cycle began long before them.
Where'd you come up with this theory? I thought there wasn't any evidence.
I have been working on this for 50 years. I have tracked down every scrap and shred of evidence. Eventually, subtle patterns start to emerge. Patterns that hint at the truth. It is difficult to explain to someone else. I cannot point to one specific thing to prove my case. It is more a feeling derived from a half century of dedicated research. But I know I'm right.
Okay.
And eventually I will be able to prove it. There were other civilizations before the Protheans. This cycle has repeated itself many times over.
If the Protheans weren't the first, then who was?
I don't know. There is barely any evidence on the Protheans, even less on those who came before them. I cannot prove my theory, but I know I am right. The galaxy is built on a cycle of extinction. Each time a great civilization rises up, it is suddenly and violently cast down. Only ruins survive. The Protheans rose up from a single world until their empire spanned the entire galaxy. Yet even they climbed to the top on the remains of those who came before. Their greatest achievements, the mass relays and the Citadel, are based on the technology of those who came before them. And then, like all the other forgotten civilizations throughout galactic history, the Protheans disappeared. I have dedicated my life to figuring out why.
They were wiped out by a race of sentient machines. The Reapers.
The Reapers? But I have never heard of... How do you know this? What evidence do you have?
There was a damaged Prothean beacon on Eden Prime. It burned a vision into my brain. I'm still trying to sort out what it all means.
Visions? Yes, that makes sense. The beacons were designed to transmit information directly into the mind of the user. Finding one that still works is extremely rare. No wonder the Geth attacked Eden Prime. The chance to acquire a working beacon, even a badly damaged one, is worth almost any risk. But the beacons were only programmed to interact with Prothean physiology. Whatever information you received would have been confused, unclear. I am amazed you were able to make sense of it at all. A lesser mind would have been utterly destroyed by the process. You must be remarkably strong-willed, Commander.
Okay, this isn't helping us find Saren or the conduit.
Of course, you are right. I am sorry, my scientific curiosity got the better of me. Unfortunately, I do not have any information that could help you find the conduit, or Saren.
I don't know why Saren wanted you out of the picture, but I think we'll be a lot better off if we bring you along.
Thank you, Commander. Saren might come after me again. I cannot think of anywhere safer than here on your ship. And my knowledge of the Protheans might be useful later on.
And her biotics will come in handy when the fighting starts.
Good to have you on the team, Liara.
Thank you, Commander. I am very grateful.
Liara?
Oh, I am afraid I am feeling a bit lightheaded.
When was the last time you ate or slept? Dr. Chakwa should take a look at you.
It is probably just mental exhaustion, coupled with the shock of discovering the Protheans' true fate. I need some time to process all this. Still, it could not hurt to be examined by a medical professional. It will give me the chance to think things over. Are we finished here, Commander?
We can talk again after you've seen the doctor. The rest of you, dismissed.
Mission reports are filed, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
We've received your report, Commander. I understand Dr. Tassoni is on the Normandy.
I assume you're taking the necessary security precautions.
Don't tell me how to do my job.
You are free to act as you see fit, Commander. Our role is to offer guidance and advice.
It's up to you if you're smart enough to listen.
Ouch.
Sorry, Counselor.
At least the mission was a success.
Apart from the utter destruction of a major Prothean ruin. Was that really necessary, Shepard?
I can just disconnect.
The Geth were crawling all over those ruins. We were lucky to make it out alive.
Of course, Commander. The mission must always take priority.
Good luck, Commander. Remember, we are all counting on you.
I am being surprisingly nice to this. Alright. Well, let's look around now that I actually have access to look around here. Alright, let's have a talk around before we go to bed. What's up?
Anything you need?
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
Is this an official evaluation, Commander? Or off the record?
Off the record.
Let's label it officially off the record. Got something on your mind?
Straight up, there's something wrong with all of this. This Saren is looking for records on some kind of galactic extinction. But we can't get backup from the Council? Sorry, Commander. There's writing on the wall here, but someone isn't reading it.
The Council doesn't want to believe anything's wrong. I'd call it human nature, but...
I hear you. It just seems like a group that's been around as long as the Council should see this coming. Sorry if I got too informal. Protocol wasn't a big focus back in Bot.
Tell me about it.
Biotic acclimation and temperance didn't last past the airlock. To the kids they hauled in, it was brain camp. Sorry, hauled in is unkind. We were encouraged to commit to an evaluation of our abilities so an understanding of biotics could be compiled. There are worse results of accidental exposure to element zero in the womb. Beats the brain tumors some kids grew up with.
Seems like you beat the odds. How many didn't make it?
Out of 100, maybe 60 have no effect. 30 suffer adverse effects, little things like brain cancer. The other 10 show enough ability to augment with implants. Not always permanent, though. Not like the cancer. Next thing you know, you're out on jump zero. And how's a kid supposed to deal with that? A station at the edge of human space.
There were other kids in the same boat, right? At least you weren't alone out there.
That's true. We did have a little circle that'd get together every night before lights out. We didn't have much to do, though. It was a research platform then, and Kinetics kept Jump Zero off the extranet to prevent leaks.
Jump Zero's a long way from home. What was it like?
The grand gateway to humanity looks a lot better in the vids. But that's my own baggage, Commander. No bearing on this.
It's a big galaxy, Lieutenant. Who knows what will come in handy?
If you say so, sir. Besides, I've got my past squared away.
Okay. I can sleep? That's kind of cool. Man, I am fucking weak. Fair amount of people here.
Shepard, what can I do for you?
What's your story, Rex?
There's no story. Go ask the Quarian if you want stories.
You Krogan lived for centuries. Don't tell me you haven't had a few interesting adventures.
Well, there was this one time the Turians almost wiped out our entire race. That was fun.
They tried the same with us, but we fought them off.
It's not the same.
It seems pretty much the same to me.
So your people were infected with a genetic mutation? An infection that makes only a few in a thousand children survive birth? And I suppose it's destroying your entire species?
I suppose it isn't all the same.
I don't expect you to understand, but don't compare humanity's fate with the Krogan.
Sorry, Rex. I wasn't trying to get you upset.
Your ignorance doesn't upset me, Shepard. As for the Krogan, I gave up on them long ago. The genophage infected us, but it's not what's killing us.
Are your people really dying?
We're sure not getting any stronger. We're too spread out. None of us are interested in staying in our own system.
What can you tell me about the genophage?
Ask the Salarians if you want details. They made it. All I know, it makes breeding nearly impossible. Thousands die in stillbirth, and most never get that far. Every Krogan is infected, everyone. And no one's rushing to find a cure.
Why don't the Krogan try to find a cure?
When was the last time you saw a Krogan scientist? You ask a Krogan, would he rather find a cure for the genophage or fight for credits? He'll choose fighting every time. It's just who we are, Shepard. I can't change that. Nobody can.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Commander, you have a minute to...
Oh, boy.
Is this duty-related, Chief?
No, sir. Well, maybe. I know things are different aboard the Normandy, but I'm concerned about the aliens. Vicarian
of course you are.
With all due respect, Commander, should they have full access to the ship?
They may not serve the Alliance, Chief, but they're allies. At least as far as Saren goes.
This is the most advanced ship in the Alliance Navy. I don't think we should give them free rein to poke around the vital systems. Engines, sensors, weapons.
You're out of line.
That's enough, Chief. You always second-guess your superiors?
Sir! No, sir. I'm sorry, I was out of line. I'll get back to my duties, Commander.
I don't like you. I'm gonna be real honest with you. She's just a straight-up racist.
Commander, nice workout. I knew working with a Spectre would be better than life at CSAC.
Have you worked with a Spectre before?
Well, no, but I know what they're like. Spectres make their own rules. You're free to handle things your way. At CSEC, you're buried by rules. The damn bureaucrats are always on your back.
For the most part, the rules are there for a reason.
Maybe. But sometimes it feels like the rules are only there to stop me from doing my work. If I'm trying to take down a suspect, it shouldn't matter how I do it, as long as I do it. But CSEC wants it done their way. Protocol and procedure come first. That's why I left.
So you just quit because you didn't like the way they do things?
There's more to it than that. It didn't start out bad, but as I rose in ranks, I got saddled with more and more red tape. CSEC's handling of Saren was typical. I just couldn't take it anymore. I hate leaving.
I hope you made the right choice. I'd hate for you to regret it later.
Well, that's sort of why I teamed up with you. It's a chance for me to get off the Citadel, see how things are done outside CSEC. Either way, I plan to make the most of this. And without CSEC headquarters looking over my shoulder, well, maybe I can get the job done my way for a change.
As long as you do your job well, you're free to go about your business as you see fit.
Thank you, Commander.
Respectable in that way. Okay, I talked to all of them here.
Hey, Commander, you know that Quarian Tally? She's been spending all her time down here asking me about our engines.
I'll tell her to leave you alone.
What? No, she's amazing. I wish my guys were half as smart as she is. Give her a month on board and she'll know more about our engines than I do. She's got a real knack for technology, that one. I can see why you wanted her to come along.
I figured she'd be a real asset to the team.
You got an eye for talent, Commander, but I'm guessing that's not why you came down here.
Fill me in on the IES stealth systems. How does it work exactly?
You can't hide a ship out in space. They emit too much heat and radiation. Too easy for sensors to pick them up, unless you find a way to capture those emissions. So our stealth systems trap the energy we give off in storage sinks built into the ship itself. No emissions to give away our location. Eventually, the sinks have to be vented. More than a few hours silent running, and they overheat. Cook us inside our own hull.
There's no way for anyone to detect us?
A visual scan can still pick us up. Anyone looking out a window can see us plain as day. But you have to be pretty close to get an actual visual out in space. Most vessels rely on scanners. As long as the stealth systems are engaged, they can't see us. Not unless we accelerate to FTL speeds.
Why doesn't it work with faster than light travel?
Cranking up the FTL, blue shifts our emissions, pushes them into frequencies too high to capture in the sinks. As soon as we make the jump, it's like setting off a flare. Sensors can pick up our location whenever we enter or exit FTL flight, but for short-range missions, our stealth systems are amazing, and we've got the only one.
I want to know more about the Normandy.
She's the best ship I've ever served on, probably the fastest vessel ever designed. She's the only one using the new Tantalus drive core.
What's so special about the Tantalus drive core?
Proportionally, it's about twice the size of any other vessel. Not only are we faster, but we can run at FTL speeds longer before we have to discharge the core.
Where else have you served, Adams?
If you name a class of Alliance ship, I've probably served on it. Everything from dreadnoughts and carriers right down to frigates like the Normandy. My last assignment was on the Tokyo, only a cruiser, but she was a good ship. Couldn't hold a candle to the Normandy, though.
Carry on, Adams.
Aye, aye, Commander.
That was Tally.
Your ship's amazing, Shepard. I've never seen a drive core like this before. I can't believe you were able to fit it into a ship this small. I'm starting to understand why you humans have been so successful. I had no idea Alliance vessels were so advanced.
The Normandy's a prototype. Cutting-edge technology.
A month ago, I was patching a makeshift fuel line into a converted tug ship in the flotilla. Now, I'm sitting on board one of the most advanced vessels in Citadel space. I have to thank you again for bringing me along. Traveling on a vessel like this is a dream come true for me.
I had no idea you found ship technology so interesting.
It comes with being a Quarian. The migrant fleet is the key to the survival of my people. Ships are our most valuable resource. But we don't have anything like this. We make do with cast-offs and second-hand equipment. We just try to keep them running for as long as we can. Some of the fleet's larger vessels date all the way back to our original flight from the Geth.
I can't believe your fleet's still using ships that are 3 centuries old.
They're constantly being repaired, modified, and refitted. They aren't pretty, but they work, mostly.
I can appreciate that.
We try to make ourselves as independent as possible on the flotilla. Grow our own food, mine, and process our own fuel. But some things we just can't make on our own. A patch to maintain the hull integrity requires raw materials we just don't have. That's why our pilgrimages are so important.
Tell me about your people.
Our lives aren't easy. Resources are scarce, and we are constantly on the move. Everything we do must in some way contribute to the continuation of the migrant fleet. There are 17 million Quarians in the flotilla, and each of us relies on the others for survival. The bonds among my people are strong. Unfortunately, we have had to surrender many of the freedoms and civil liberties other species take for granted.
What kind of freedoms?
Well, it's illegal for parents to have more than one child. If our population grows too much, it would strain our resources to their breaking point. Of course, we also can't allow our numbers to become too few. If our population is in decline, the rule against single births is temporarily repealed.
Huh.
In extreme cases of population decline, incentives are even offered to encourage multiple births, though the Conclave hasn't had to take such measures in nearly a century.
That's your government.
The Conclave is our civilian branch of government. Each ship can elect a representative to serve on the Conclave and make decisions that affect the fleet as a whole. On matters that affect an individual ship, however, the captain has the final say. It's a tradition that dates back to the early days, when the fleet was governed by martial law. Fortunately, most captains nowadays are smart enough to have an elected council from their crew to give them advice and guidance.
So the ultimate power rests with elected officials?
In practice, the Conclave and the respective council for each ship tend to set the rules that govern our daily lives. But in theory, we are still under military jurisdiction. The five top-ranking military officials in the fleet serve on the Admiralty Board. These five have the power to overrule any decision by the Conclave in case of emergency. To do so requires unanimous agreement among the Admiralty. And they can only do this once. After that, the entire board must resign their posts. It's a safeguard that served us well. In nearly three centuries, the Admiralty Board has only overruled the Conclave four times.
I want to know more about the Geth.
I doubt I can tell you anything you don't already know. It's been almost three centuries since they drove my people into exile. All I know is the story of their origins, what they were when we created them, and how they turned on us.
Interesting.
The Geth were originally created to serve as an automated manual labor force. Initially, their intelligence was as limited as any VI. Over time, we made small modifications to their programming to allow them to perform more varied and complex tasks, bringing them closer and closer to true AI status.
How come the Council didn't step in and stop you?
This wasn't true AI research. We may have been skirting the bounds of the law, but we never did anything that was actually illegal. The changes were so insignificant, so gradual, that we were able to control them. Or so we thought. But one thing we underestimated was the power of the neural network. A million Geth thinking simultaneously created an inherently unstable matrix.
So the Geth share brain power?
Many of the Geth's logic systems were designed to work in concert with other nearby Geth. Basically, the more of them you have in the group, the smarter they are.
Huh.
So there's some sort of group consciousness?
No, nothing like that. They cannot share sensory data or information. Their programming cannot handle that much simultaneous input. Each Geth maintains an individual awareness and identity. The neural network only operates on a process-based level. It's basically the synthetic equivalent of a subconscious. But when they're in close proximity, they can coordinate low-level functional processes, freeing up more capacity for original or independent thought.
What made them rebel?
As we built more and more Geth, their effective intelligence became more sophisticated, more abstract. One day, a Geth began to ask its Quarian overseer questions about the nature of its existence. Am I alive? Why am I here? What is my purpose? As you can imagine, this caused a near panic among my people.
I don't see what's so bad about those questions.
The Geth were created to engage in mundane, repetitive, or dangerous manual labor. That's fine for machines, but it won't satisfy a sentient being for long. The Geth were showing signs of rudimentary self-awareness and independent thought. If the Geth were intelligent, then we were essentially using them as slaves. It was inevitable the newly sentient Geth would rebel against their situation. We knew they would rise up against us, so we acted first. A general order went out across all Quarian-controlled systems to permanently deactivate all Geth. The Geth responded to this order violently.
You can't blame them for fighting for their survival.
We had no other choice. The Geth were already on the verge of revolution. By acting quickly, we had a chance to end the war before it began. The hope was that most of the Geth would still be little more than machines, incapable of organized resistance. But they had progressed much further than anyone anticipated. The war was long and bloody. Millions upon millions of Quarians died at their hands. In the end, we were forced to flee our own homeworld. We feared the Geth would pursue us, but they never came beyond the Veil. Now we drift through space, exiled, searching for a way to reclaim what was once ours.
It's hard to feel sorry for you. Your ancestors tried to wipe out another species.
We made a mistake when we created the Geth in the first place. But we did not make a mistake when we went to war against them. If we had not acted, they would have wiped us out. They're a synthetic life form. They have no use for organics. None. Why do you think they cut themselves off from the rest of the galaxy? Why do you think they've killed every organic being who's ever tried to contact them?
I didn't mean to offend you.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to get so worked up. Most Quarians tend to have pretty strong opinions about the Geth.
I want to know more about the pilgrimage.
When my people reach maturity, we leave our birth ships and seek acceptance with a new crew. It's necessary to maintain genetic diversity among the fleet. But no ship wants to accept someone who will be a burden on them. So, to prove our worth, we embark on a pilgrimage. We set out alone, leaving the flotilla and our families behind us. We only return once we have found something of value we can bring back to the fleet. This is presented as a gift to the captain of the respective ship we wish to join. If the gift is accepted, we are welcomed into the crew.
I can't believe they just send you off alone.
It's not like they just cast us out. Before we leave, we are given lessons in how to survive outside the flotilla, and given gifts to help us on our journey. We also receive implants to fight off sickness and disease. Generations of living in an isolated and highly controlled environment have left our immune systems weaker than most. By the time we leave the fleet, we are well equipped for the pilgrimage. This is a rite of passage for all Quarians. If it were dangerous, our numbers would suffer. Virtually every pilgrimage ends with a triumphant return and the ritual presentation of the gift to one of the fleet's captains.
Can a captain choose to reject the gift?
That doesn't happen often. Most captains are eager to increase the size of their crew. It increases their own standing in our society. Even when the gift is not particularly valuable, the captain usually accepts it out of a sense of tradition. However, there is a stigma to presenting a substandard gift. It's not the best way to make a good impression on a new community. Most pilgrims don't return until they find something worthwhile.
I want to talk about something else.
Like what?
I should go.
See you later.
Ah, my brain, it hurts. Alright, well, that's enough for today. Thank you everyone for watching. I very much appreciate it. I wanted to say stick by for the time being. Sorry this is such a late stream and also a short stream as well. I'll be streaming later today as well, so don't you worry about that. I'll see you guys in the next video. And remember, every day is a gamble, so make sure you roll that dice to the highest number you got. Thank you guys and be safe.